transition videos with Suki Kangas and Tramoldo.
Thank you for helping me.
Yeah. Suki!
Yeah.
Oh, there are many, many teachers like me can do a simple basic drawings. Can you help us, please?
Yeah, I can teach you how to do some basic drawings.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Do you have your paper and your pencil? Do you have your paper and your pencil? Get out paper and pencil or pen, whatever, and let's start
and
drawing.
An eraser?
And an eraser?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Let's go start.
So I'm going to teach you some basic tips, but for the sake of time, we're going to go a little bit fast. So whenever you want to, you can watch this video again, and you can pause the video, and you can practice. Okay, let's start. We're going to do really basic stuff. Really basic. Okay, ready?
Okay.
So we're going to start with expressions on a face. So here I have a face. It's just a circle. Really easy. Now we're going to put a couple dots kind of right in the middle of it. Those are the eyes. There's a nose and a mouth. We'll make them smiling.
Whee!
And let's put the eyebrows, let's make them curves like this
for now. Okay.
So this is how you make a happy face. And to change the expression, the face of the person, what they're feeling, all you have to do is change the eyebrows and the mouth. So let's try, make another one. Now let's do the same thing with the circles.
Okay.
Let's make the eyebrows curved like this.
Oh, nice.
There you go. So up, curve like this is like happy. Curve like this is like hee. Or it could be embarrassed. If you have pink, what you could do is you could put a couple. Oh my gosh, she's blushing.
Okay.
Another thing we can do is change the mouth. Let's leave the eyebrows. We're gonna leave them there. And now we're going to put the mouth like this. Oh, it's sad. So the eyebrows are curved up like that, and the mouth is curved down like that, and it's sad.
So the tip is the mouth and?
Mouth and eyebrows.
Okay.
And then there's other things. Let's see. Let's change the eyebrows again. Okay. And now we're gonna make them mad. So mad eyebrows go down in the middle.
Oh my gosh.
Now he's mad. If you want to make him even more mad, put them even more down and more up over here.
What do you mean?
Well, sometimes you might need to draw,
somebody
mad. Okay. So these are how you make the eyebrows and the mouth change the expression. Now let's change the eyes a little bit. We'll close the eyes. There's a few different ways to draw closed eyes. One of them is like this. Now this person is kind of sleepy. Now let's make the person praying. We're gonna go up a little bit on the eyebrows.
Okay.
And in the mouth, we're gonna make the person talking. So there's a few ways to do this. I'm just gonna show you a couple ways. One of them is to draw a smaller, kind of sad facey thing. Then make an oval inside and fill that. Now he's saying something. You can write what he's saying. So now he's praying.
Is it praying?
Huh?
He's praying?
Yeah, it's praying. Does it look like praying?
Yeah.
Cool. All right.
Fabulous, Suki. Fabulous. I like it so much. Now, I am praying.
Oh, nice! He's praying.
Yeah.
Oh, she did just a circle. He fell in it like this. This is easier. Now it looks like he's going. Oh. Maybe he's singing. Okay. So sometimes you're gonna have two people and you want them looking at each other. How do you do this?
Yes, well, please help us.
Well, one way you can do it is you can just dry your face, but put the mouth and eyes and nose over on one side of it. But then there's a cool way you can do this. Okay, so we're gonna make him look up. Draw a circle. Mm-hmm. And to make him look up, we're going to draw a curved line like this. You're going to erase this line. It's just for you, to help you. And you're going to put the eyes on the line like this. Now when he's looking up, you kind of, the nose, we're going to draw it like this instead of down. And then we're going to put the mouth up here too, and his eyebrows. And then you erase this line that you created to help you. This is why it's good to have a pencil and an eraser.
See? Whoa, I can't
do it. Ooh! Now he's looking up. Now let's make him look to the side. So again, just a plain old circle. You're going to draw a dotted line going like this. Or draw a line, a soft line with your pencil. Now you're going to put the eyes over here. One over there, one over there. You're going to draw the nose from the side. It's kind of like a triangle, part of a triangle there.
Ooh.
And then you're going to draw the mouth over here. So everything is on this line over here. And the eyebrows. And don't be afraid, especially with a cartoon drawing like this, don't be afraid to touch the line. Go over the line. He's got a big eyebrow on it. And then erase this. And if you want some hair on here, you can draw some hair. And draw ear. Ear is just like curve this half of the circle, go around again with the hair. There you go.
Ooh, I like this one.
And if you want to do down, you do the same thing, but you draw your curve line over here. Eyes. Put your nose over here. Put the nose and the mouth close together because If I'm here, it looks like they're like this. If I go down, it looks like they're closer. Like that. Now he's looking down.
This line is very important for to make the line
is just to help you know where to put the eyes so you're facing the way you want it to go. And then you erase that line. And he needs a lot more hair because you're looking at the top of his head. Unless you want him bald. Or maybe this time it's a girl. Okay? So that's how you do expressions and pointing the face where you want it. Let's draw some bodies doing things. Oh.
Yeah?
Oh, I forgot.
Yeah.
I'm going to show you, these are some examples that I made.
Okay.
So again, you can, not that close, a little bit back.
Okay.
Again, you can pause the video and you can use this to practice me drawing some different expressions. Sometimes I did the curved eyebrows going this way, sometimes down, sometimes straight, sometimes like this, and then I change the mouth every time, and it gives you a very different expression. So you can practice drawing these and get some cool ideas. Okay. Let's move on to a person doing things. And I'm just going to stick with stick figures. Person makes wee. So this is a person, we're going to make this person do different things. So let's start with walking. So your body is going to be straight and you're going to have your legs bent a little bit and your arms a little bit bent like this. And now the person is walking.
Hey.
You did it!
Yeah!
Very nice. If you want to make this a girl, you just put a skirt. Put some here. And it's a girl walking. Okay.
Thank you.
Let's start again. Let's do running this time. Your head. When you're running, not only are your arms and legs going to be like this, but you're going to be leaning forward because you're going to be trying to go forward faster. So let's make him leaning. Let's go this way. We'll make him lean forward with his body.
Okay.
One leg is going forward. The other leg is pushing him back. You got arms doing stuff like this. And to make him look like he's moving fast, you can draw a few lines like this.
Nice, deep Suki.
I like it. Thanks. So there he's drawn. He's running.
Okay, we're
drawn.
We have only 2 minutes.
We have only 3 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's show you the example page I have.
Yeah.
Again, you can pause the video and practice drawing these several different things, and you can try some other stuff.
Okay.
Okay. Let's draw a church.
Well, maybe
falling.
Yeah.
Oh, falling is fun, but they can pause the video and practice
okay.
Falling. Okay. Let's draw a church. I'm gonna start with a line straight in the middle of the page, like this, and then a shorter line on the side. And over here, a shorter line. And you're going to connect these like a box.
Again, please. Line.
A longer, a taller
okay.
line in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
A shorter line on this side.
Okay.
A shorter line over here, a little bit farther away.
Mm-hmm.
Connect these like this.
Whoa.
This is how to draw a 3D church. You can also draw a 2D church. Very nice. Mm-hmm. Let's put a door. Oh, yeah. Let's put a door on this side. And there's a door over here. There's some windows.
Door.
We need a roof.
Yes. What do you think
of here? No, I'm gonna put this here and erase the inside. And let's put a cross. Ta-da! It's a church! Oh, let's put a little line over here that the roof is going behind the building. Okay? And most churches have a sign. There you go. That's how you make a church. Let's show them the page I made.
Okay.
So here's a simple house and a church. Here's how to draw a box. Again, you just draw a rectangle, you draw some lines going at an angle, and you connect the lines. And that's a city. Let's show them the other one.
Okay. One more?
Yeah. Okay. Okay, this is the last one. This looks a little scary, but it's not. It's just different pieces. So here's the foreground. Here's how you can make some hills between that. Here's, I drew two ways to make mountains. One of them is a pointy mountain that's like a tall, very big mountain. Or you could just do big, tall, round mountains. This is how you draw a river. You go like this, and then you do another one that goes, that gets wider and wider as you go. That's how you do a river. You could also do a road like this, or you could do a road like this. This road goes under a hill a little bit. And I mean, person. You can draw your people, and you can go. Paul was traveling to another place. This is how you draw. This is how you draw a cloud. The clouds have a, the bottom is flat, and then you go. Bah, 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 bah. And this is how you draw a rain cloud, a big storm cloud. Do the flat again, but on one side you're gonna go way up there. Bah, 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 bah. And then it has like a little thing. There's rain, lightning. Water is always flat. So even in this river, when I did the little water things, I made them straight. And a tree is just and stick a trunk on there, put some more. I did a different tree and I didn't erase that line. What I did on this, what you can do when you're making drawings for your class, you can draw them in pencil and don't worry about making a mistake or whatever. It's pencil. You can erase it. And you draw on top of it crisp lines with a Sharpie, and then you go back and erase the pencil. There's some pencil lines on this. And that's how you draw some basic drawings.
Well, Fabio, Suki, thanks for helping us and teachers like me. Okay, thank you, brothers and sisters, for to be with us. And see you in the next video.